नमस्कार, मैं मधुर गुप्ता हूँ। स्मैव रिसर्च द्वारा आयोजित चेंजिंग कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर पोस्ट लॉकडाउन इन एसोसिएशन विद ऑप्टिशियन इंडिया में आप सभी का स्वागत करता हूँ। अनलॉकिंग द पावर ऑफ रिसर्च बाय अंडरस्टैंडिंग द एंड कंज्यूमर एंड देयर बिहेवियर। इस वेब सीरीज में हम इंडस्ट्री के कई दिग्गज एक्सपर्ट्स के साथ आज बात करेंगे, जो कि देश भर से सबसे प्रोमिनेंट रिटेल आउटलेट्स को बिलोंग करते हैं। आज हमारे साथ हैं इंडस्ट्री के फ्यूचर लीडर श्री रोहित गुप्ता जी। ही इज द चीफ प्रोडक्ट एंड मार्केटिंग एट जीकेबी ऑप्टिकल। ये कंपनी के सप्लाई चेन मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजी बोथ ऑन ग्राउंड एज वेल एज डिजिटल के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है। बीइंग अ कॉम्पिटिटिव स्पोर्ट्समैन ऑल हिज लाइफ हैज अलाउड हिम टू स्टे फोकस्ड, हम्बल एंड डिटरमाइंड टू एक्सेल। रोहित जी हैज हिज रूट्स इन कोलकाता। He completed his schooling at La Martiniere for boys. He then went to the University of Edinburgh for his bachelor's in business. After graduating, he decided to come back to Kolkata to join the family business. That's GKB Optical. Having already taken the reins of the company at an early age, we can't wait to see what he does next. Hi, sir. How are you?
I'm doing good, Madhur. Hope everything's okay with you as well.
Yeah, fine. Thank you so much. I'll take you directly to questions.
Sure.
How most of your buyers have been like post-COVID? Right. If you rate them from 1 to 3, are they very concerned towards COVID, somewhat concerned towards COVID, or not concerned about?
Well, I would say that it's basically been based on the time period. You know, when the COVID breakout happened, I think everyone was very concerned about the whole situation, with an immediate lockdown happening and the country going completely on a lockdown situation. So at that time, people were taking it very seriously. I think today people are very aware of the situation and they know that this is going to be the new normal way of living life. And the best way to do is to make sure they take their own precautions before they step out of their homes. So as far as our buyers are concerned, I feel like they're all following the norms of the government. So as the lockdown was getting eased up, they were moving around a little bit more freely. And because even with time, they were also figuring out, okay, we need to take our own precautions, like wearing the mask or wearing our gloves before we exit our homes. So I think as the lockdowns have been easing up, I think the concern of the consumer is also getting eased up as that process is moving ahead.
What kind of consumers are walking in post-COVID? Basically, who are having that eye problem? They are the predominant ones, or the ones who have fashion at the back of their mind?
Yeah, I think it's a clear answer. I think definitely with more on leaning towards a health platform. So most of the consumers who are placing their orders with us during COVID have been completely based on need. Either they're looking to replace their current glasses, or they're looking to buy a spare pair, or they're even looking to replenish on their contact lenses. The fashion aspect is completely taken a backseat, and it will take a backseat for a good period of time. And just because the fact is that people are staying at home, and there's going to be still an active way of life, that staying at home, working from home. So there's no real requirement on a fashion quotient. And I think we can also measure that based on the huge decline in sunglass sales, because sunglasses is a product which is directly proportionate to fashion. So I've seen there's a huge decline in sunglass sales, as well as cosmetic contact lenses, which would be colored contact lenses. So anything related to fashion has sort of taken a backseat, and completely right now need-based products are being sold.
Identify the main category of your consumers pre-COVID.
Yeah.
Were they mostly the returning ones, or the new ones used to be the main customer base for you?
Well, pre-COVID, we were definitely more relying on our returning consumers. I think we have, during this COVID period, I've felt like we have gained a lot more new consumers than we were getting returning consumers pre-COVID. I think it's because of a lot of new steps that we're taking as a company to capture these new consumers. So as far as to ensure, what we have done during COVID is to be very active on any form of communication, especially on a digital platform, to be relevant in their minds. And the consumer's mind is going to be key, because they're trying to look for the safest optical chain. And because everyone's going with the hygiene perspective, so it's very important that you're in that space and you communicate seamlessly with all the consumers about this. And I also see it going sort of both ways with moving ahead, where returning and new consumers are coming to GKB, where because the optician, which sort of meets the highest safety standards, provides the consumers convenience by adding new services, new features onto them, and also being will become inherently the leader of the pack.
In general, how has COVID impacted the shopping behavior of your returning consumers?
Okay, I think so. COVID has impacted the behavior in many different aspects. I think the most clear change was how they're consuming and how they're purchasing the products. So as based on data from our stores and how we've seen in the sales, is that most of the consumers are purchasing their products through phone calls. They're calling our managers, they're calling our stores, very few walk-ins. So you can still see that consumers are still very reluctant to walking inside the shop, maybe because of the safety aspect of it. So most of the buying patterns is changing based on phone calls. Most of our managers and our sales teams are communicating with them through their phones. So by regularly contacting them through SMSs, through emailers, and even widely using WhatsApp as a way of communication. So any sort of product releases, they're just going directly through a WhatsApp situation. However, the people who are walking in are, it's very low. And what we have seen that number is improving based on the situation in those cities. So for example, with Bangalore being a city which has improved widely in terms of its COVID effectiveness, we have seen a lot more consumers walking into our shops and being more comfortable purchasing inside the store rather than just calling us or using our e-commerce channel.
Who are the new buyers? You know, any idea what attracted them towards your outlets?
Well, I think during COVID, the new consumers who have been purchasing from us quite similarly reflect our existing demographic. So usually the age group of GKB consumers are between the ages of 30 and 50. And most of them are international brand wearers. So I haven't seen a huge change in that particular aspect. However, we have seen a good surge in millennial sales. That's because of our newly launched e-commerce channel, which we launched about 3 weeks ago. So I think most of those, because again, the millennial culture is buying online and they're more comfortable buying optical on an e-commerce platform. So I think that's where our new consumers are coming from. And also with us being a little bit more active on social media, you know, for more of an organic following, we've also seen a younger age group of consumers coming to us now.
Now, as you said, you know, the footfalls are not forthcoming.
Yeah.
What measures can be brought in where, you know, the footfalls could be increased?
Right. So, see, as far as footfalls are concerned, that's going to be a problem for a good period of time. You know, as far as what you can do for whatever footfalls you want to bring is, firstly, definitely you have to be absolutely seamless on your safety measures. So all of our shops have to be incredibly sanitized based on the industry standard. All team members need to be wearing masks, gloves, so that if any consumer walks in, they feel that they're protected. Sanitization of all their eyewear before they do any trials, especially when they're doing their eye testing, because eye testing is something you have to enter a particular shop to get done. And you can't do it at somebody's home. Even today's technology doesn't allow you to get 100% accuracy home eye testing. So in that aspect, you have to make sure that the safety measures are up to mark. And we've also, for example, we've in the East region, we've introduced a new service, which is a home service, which allows people to consume or select their eyewear from their homes. So even the people who are going and visiting from our team are wearing PPE suits to ensure that there's no infection and even the consumer feels a little bit more on the safer side. And I think as of now, most of these measures will help bring some form of footfall. You know, that pre-COVID situation where promotions or the price was a main reason why consumers were coming in, and that was a footfall driver. That's not going to be the situation for some time now, in my opinion.
Right. And if we say that, you know, are there any unusual complaints or incidents or activities you have noticed from the buyers post-COVID?
No, I feel like no unusual complaints or incidents. But what we have seen is that a lot of consumers are wanting all their products to be delivered to their homes, which is something which was not very apparent before. You know, we would always promote, or we would ask our consumers to come to the store and pick up their glasses, because if there's any need of small adjustments, you know, fitting issues, they could all be done immediately at the store. But I feel like most of the consumers are just asking for their products to be delivered at home, and to also get them serviced at home. So when the person is delivering, we also have a sort of fitting kit with them. So in case on the spot fitting needs to be done, it's done at their homes. So that's the only sort of change that has gone about.
What, according to you, is the new normal? You know, if we say the preference, as you already have mentioned, that, you know, people are calling your team members and asking for home deliveries, avoiding visiting the stores. Now, yeah. That, say, if that is the first category of consumers, so then what is the second, what is the third in terms of, you know, the buying patterns from your websites, from, you know, asking for, products on phone and then collecting in person, then visiting the outlets, asking for home delivery, or visiting the outlets and taking the delivery themselves.
Now, Madhav, based on the points that you've shown to me over here, I think the most relevant and the most common is the home delivery service. That's very clear. I think that's being done for at least 80 to 90% of our consumers currently during COVID. Second, I would say a wide use of our e-commerce platform. I think a lot of people are, even though we've just recently launched it, we have seen some encouraging numbers in terms of people actually coming and conversing with us on that platform. You know, so that's also being widely used. As far as people coming and coming into the shops, again, I think that's still, visiting outlets is going to be, it's still quite low. You know, even with since the last lockdown got eased up, was when most of the cities allowed shopping malls to become operational. So even with that happening, we haven't seen anything very encouraging with malls opening up, because people are still apprehensive on moving about and entering these sort of areas. So I think the same goes for home delivery services, people placing orders on phone, and using the website, for sure.
Right. What are your existing consumers looking at? You know, premium luxury, or their preferences towards the affordable luxury segment, or the house brand?
Yeah. So based on these three different categories, GKB Opticals caters to all three, actually. Even though we're sort of segmented ourselves in the mid to mid premium category, we also cater to all these three subcategories which you mentioned here. I see that the premium luxury segment for sure will be a lot slower in movement because of their sort of pattern in the past. You don't see that as a big change, but I think everyone will be a little bit more careful because of the situation. You know, and I know for a fact that everyone's business in some way has been affected. So that segment will be a lot slower, in my opinion. Affordable luxury, however, what we call it is sort of a core brand or designer brand segment. I feel that will be the most fast moving category for us. Even during COVID, based on all the purchases of returning consumers, we've seen that a lot of them have not degraded themselves on the frame that they've purchased. Based on what they purchased before, they purchased something of the same level, if not higher. They haven't really degraded themselves. So I think that affordable luxury segment is that sort of sweet spot where people are still comfortable spending. And then after that would be followed by the house brands. I think house brand segments are is an area which is gaining popularity. And if you're ensured that your quality is good and your price is good and you have a regular promotion running on it, I think your house brands will be a good seller for you as well.
Right. Yeah. Now, are consumers open to spend more towards lenses or frames? I'm talking from the perspective of a concept like upselling, which used to be a predominant thing in the sales. Is this kind of a pattern still prevalent?
Yeah, I think this is it's a very strong pattern, and I see the pattern never changing really in this particular part of it. I've always believe that the ability to upsell lenses is always tougher than the frame. The frame at the end of it is 90% is always the consumer's choice. You know, what fits their face, what is to their liking. I think it's only 10% if they ask, or even if the sales team, you know, suggests to them that, you know, it looks good or gives them a compliment. And maybe that could strike them to be like, okay, it looks good. But most of it is just the consumer selecting the frame. As far as the lenses go, there's a lot which goes behind it. And one thing I believe is that with lenses, it's all about dispensing knowledge that the staff has. One thing I also believe in is that we don't sell lenses, we dispense them. So the knowledge that the staff has in terms of understanding what the consumer's requirement is, because even lenses today, the technology has gone so far ahead that it's not just a stock lens which is there in your inventory and you just sort of cut them into your design. It's based on their lifestyle. So if suppose somebody's a little bit more sporty, somebody requires more screen usage. So the lenses have been designed in that manner. And a lot of it comes from the knowledge and the dispensing capabilities of the team members at the store. So I believe that with the situation of COVID and less number of consumers walking into shops, the upselling of lenses is not going to be easy. It's not going to be an easy job.
According to you, is there any particular product range or products in specific that the consumers have been asking for specifically after COVID?
Absolutely. I think one standout product, which a lot of consumers are asking for, and it's become like a regular dispensing product now for us, is blue protective lenses. Clearly, because of the situation where people are staying at home, screen time on your various digital devices has increased. Your laptops, your TVs, your phones. It has doubled, if not tripled, for a lot of people. So the requirement for blue protective lenses is high in demand. It wasn't a low demanding product pre-COVID. But I feel like because of the COVID situation, it has surged more importance in this segment, and people are more attracted to this product. Even a product, a new product, which is not very popular in the market today, called PC lenses, which is non-powered blue cut. So people who do not have power, but are often on digital devices, require a pair which has blue protective lenses. So that's a new product which is not very popular, but I see that gaining popularity in the next couple of months. And for sure, even safety eyewear. I think when COVID, just the first initial months of COVID in the month of March and April, a lot of people were creating these protective shields and these goggles. So I thought maybe it was only for people working at the factory level or more of a manufacturing area. It could work, it could be more effective there. But we have seen a couple of our consumers asking for this product. So we are partnering with certain companies who are manufacturing these. And again, we are definitely promoting all India made. So we are definitely promoting those manufacturers who are creating in-house here in the country and reducing our, you know, partnerships with China for sure when it comes to production of this product.
That's wonderful. And in your opinion, is there any possibility that could lead us back to the earlier normal?
Of course, I think there's always a possibility. And the main situation is that you have to, and you have to stay positive, that your normal business will come back at some point. You know, I always remain optimistic and I never sort of jump into what the situation's like. You know, I think you have to adapt. What has happened is it's growing. COVID is not going out anytime soon. So I believe you make the best of the situation. You keep yourself and the team motivated, and just make sure that you make the right moves at the right time, and you're reducing your cost from your back end. I also believe that as a retailer, it would be essential that you create positive collaborations with your suppliers, with your landlords, because a lot of our stores, we have these landlords where we are paying rent with. So to ensure like a collaborative synergy is made, because, you know, there's a lot of pressure being put down on each level. So maybe on retailers, maybe on manufacturers, suppliers, all of them. So everyone has to understand that they're all going through different problems and they need to come to a mutual agreement on each of their businesses, you know? So I believe it will be a strong, strong move for retailers to collaborate with each one of them to create a balance, for sure.
Right. What, according to you, would be the scenario 2 months down the line and then 6 months down the line?
Tough to say. I think what I feel is that in the next 2 months, I think the situation will be pretty much the same as it is today. I think still there's a lot of consumers still try to, you know, fathom and sort of understand how the situation is. And I think they're now getting to that point where they're leaving their homes and understanding that this is how we have to live, you know. I think it's very tough for me to call what the situation will be at the end of this year. COVID is rising rapidly, and you can see with situations like Chennai going back to a complete lockdown, you know, it shows that it's not, you know, even though we're moving ahead, it can also come back to a situation where you go back to what it was in the month of March and April or so, you know. So it's very tough to say, but again, I believe that this industry is one which is, again, it's a requirement, you know, and it will always be there. But you just need to ensure that you're communicating in the right way and just staying positive in your consumer's mind. I think that will be the key, but very tough for me to say how the situation will be 6 months down the line, for sure.
Considering that, you know, a COVID vaccine comes out, then what would be your...
That would be fantastic. I think, but what I do know is that when the vaccine comes out, it takes minimum of 5 to 6 months for a mass production of it to happen. So see, I see that it's going to, this whole process of, you know, businesses being affected, including ours, will be a whole year process. So since it started in March, I believe, you know, our business will sort of see a sort of normalcy until next year, March. That's how I predict it. But yeah, if the vaccine comes out soon, that would be fantastic. And I think that would give a lot more people immediate encouragement to move around, you know, knowing in the back of their minds that there is a cure out there. But for now, there is no cure and still a lot of unsettledy. So I think tough to say.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Rohitji. You have given us a wonderful insight on your consumers, how they are behaving post the lockdown.
Thank you. You're very welcome. And I hope my information helps.
Yeah, we'll be interacting with you again, you know, in a couple of months and check on the progress.
I hope so. I hope most of my points, you know, the points would change in the next couple of months. I really hope so too.
We take it in the positive light and we'll try and get in touch once again. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Father. Thank you for your time.